Do you have clay soil? Do you know somebody with clay soil? Soil that when it gets wet, it becomes muddy. It sticks to your shoes. It's real gumbo. I want to show you the one addition that you can add to your clay soil that will unlock its natural fertility just by adding. If you have clay soil or you've worked with clay soil, you know that clay soil has to be treated like a real diva. It can be finicky, it can be damaged, it can be abused. If you've ever worked it, when it's wet at the wrong time, you know that you can end up with a pond or a mud puddle very easily. Natural clays are used in cosmetics, in pottery, in our dishes and toilet bowls, and so much more. People have used clay since the beginning of time. Moisten the clay and you make a mud brick house. If you want to get fancier, then you take the clay blob and you fire it and you end up with bricks. Isn't that amazing? So how do we, or how should we, grow plants in clay soil? I'm getting to the not so secret ingredient to unlock the natural fertility of your clay soil. But first, let me give you a few rules working with clay soils. First, treat it with respect. Never work your clay soils when they're wet. Moist is okay, but not mud puddle wet. Never circulate on your bare clay soil when it's wet. Certainly not with equipment, no tractors, no vehicle. Even livestock or people, when it's wet, will compress it and pack it down. Keep your clay soil covered. Grass is fantastic. Cover crop, plant and crop residues and mulch are all good. Remember, if your soil is wet and it gets packed, you get bricks. If you looked at clay particles under a microscope, you'd see they're kind of like a deck of cards packed tightly together. They're called platelets. And if you can get organic matter to mix in, it spreads those cards apart, allowing roots, allowing air, allowing soil life to work in between. Organic matter is so vital to clay soils. And it also holds more water because clay naturally holds a lot of water, but so does the organic matter. If you want to find out more how to make your soil really come alive, check out our soil course at permaculture.study and start today for free. Load your clay soil with organic matter. Now I'm getting to the secret ingredient, wood chips. There's nothing that you could add that's organic matter that will unlock the natural fertility in clay as well as wood chips does. Let me show you how. If you were to chip a whole tree, something this size, you would end up with a lot of core, inner wood, a lot of carbon to very little bark. And that makes a big difference in carbon to nitrogen ratio. The carbon is all in the core. The nitrogen is all in the bark. So if you chip a whole tree, you could have a 500:1 carbon to nitrogen ratio. If you chip branches that are 2 inches or less, a lot less carbon to the amount of nitrogen. So you could be at a 50:1 carbon to nitrogen ratio. And if you get it in leaf, wow, you could get it so close to being compostable that it will start heating right in the truck. Let me give you some of the benefits of using organic matter in the form of wood chips for any soil, but especially for clay soils. The first one is it really retains water. All organic matter retains water. Organic matter also provides nutrients, so your soil will be naturally more fertile. Wood chips will help slow the rain down and reduce the erosion. It's that slow spread and sink principle used in permaculture. Wood chips is great for that. Using wood chips is also, as a mulch, a great way for doing weed suppression. You'll just get less weeds. You still may get some, but it'll be less, certainly depending on how thick a layer of wood chips you're using. And finally, wood chips are great for temperature moderation. Try it. Dig underneath some wood chips and you'll find, the soil is so much cooler And if it's a hot sunny day, think of it. If your soil isn't baking in the sun, it won't bake into a thick brick. Let me give you a few tips on how to properly use wood chips with clay soil. Let me start by what not to do. Don't use 100% conifers for your wood chips. Some of you in some areas, that may be all that's available. That's not the ideal. I'm not saying you never should use it, but realize that it just will take a lot longer for those wood chips to really take effect. 50% or less conifer material, pine, spruce, fir, that's okay. You can mix it up and that's fine. Another don't is don't mix your wood chips into your soil. Layer it. How to do it? Layer. Put your soil, and in this case, they actually raise the soil, just clay, and then layer it on the wood chips. And in this case, they put 1 to 2 feet depending on the bed. That's how you want to do it. If you mix it in, that wood chips that's mixed into the soil will take forever to degrade or decompose. Putting it on top gives lots of air circulation into your wood chips and it allows it to decompose nicely. Clay is mineral rich. If you want the perfect trifecta of healthy and productive soil, you need the mineral content, you need the organic matter content, and you need the soil life. When you combine clay with wood chips, you get those three. And you really can unlock the huge potential that is just lying dormant in your clay soil. Because in the end, isn't that what you want? Soil that's fertile, that's easier to work, that will grow healthy, tasty, and nutrient-dense food, and give you a beautiful landscape?